In order to fake the pregnancy, I had to gain weight. So I started eating tons of food. I would have pizza every other day. I ate 2 pints of ice cream a day. And every time I passed by a fast food place, I would pick up something to eat. I was gaining a little bit of weight, so people believed me when I said I was pregnant. Finally, the wedding came around. I was so relieved once we were married because I knew I had to eventually go to the doctor. And I had decided that once the doctor said that I wasn't pregnant, I would put on a show and pretend that I just lost the baby. Well, when it finally happened, my husband straight up asked me if I made it all up. And I told him yes. It literally took him 1 hour to move out of the apartment. He went straight to get a restraining order, and my parents sent me to a psychiatrist. But you see, we're still married. He hasn't filed for divorce, so I think I should reach out to him. I know he and I will end up together. What do you guys think?
I just got these from Hourglass. Let's try them out. This is the shade Crush, and it's an actual velvet finish. Like, it feels like velvet on my lips. This is the shade Indulge. I think this is gonna be my favorite. This is shade Hint. Okay, this is my favorite. I'm not gonna try every single shade on because then I can't give them away. And of course, I wanna share them with you guys. I'm truly obsessed with my makeup today. I don't think I've ever done a look like this because I'm all about colors, but so 90s, right? Cute. All the shades are actually stunning. They're really beautiful. And the finish on the lips is so amazing. I've never tried anything like this. So good job, Hourglass.
Story time about how I caught my husband with his best friend in bed. Who, by the way, is a guy. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. I knew that my husband was bi before we got married and it never bothered me. In fact, that's how we met. A few years ago, I was dating this guy. And we had an open relationship and he would tell me about this other guy that he was hooking up with. Well, he introduced me to his male friend, and we actually ended up hooking up. A few months later, we became boyfriend and girlfriend, and a few years later, we got married. So I always knew my husband was bi. Here's when his best friend comes into the picture. Let's call him Kenny. Kenny's been best friends with my husband for over 7 years. They've known each other longer than I've known my husband. But get this, Kenny is also married. Kenny would sometimes sleep over our house when it was really late. A few weeks ago, he slept over. I went to bed, but at 4 in the morning, I wake up and my husband is not in bed. So I go looking for him and I hear a noise coming from the guest bedroom. I walk in and see that my husband is tied to the bed. Guess what they were doing? Part two is up. I see my husband is tied to the bed and his best friend Kenny is doing things to him. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. I was so shocked I ran to the toilet and vomited. Kenny went straight to put on his clothes, but my husband was still tied to the damn bed. Before Kenny could start untying him, I straight up started punching my husband in the face, the chest, the neck. I felt uncontrollable rage for the first time. This whole time that I thought they were just best friends, my husband and his male best friend Kenny are hooking up behind my back. Here's when I really started to lose control. Kenny tried to pull me off of my husband, so I noticed that they had a bunch of candles lit. So I grabbed 2 candles and threw them straight at Kenny's head. One of them missed, but the other one got him. So Kenny grabbed his phone and started calling 911. Mind you, my husband is still tied to the bed at this point. Then I grabbed another candle and poured all the hot wax on top of my husband's you know what. Part 3 is up. Story time about how I faked a pregnancy to get my boyfriend to marry me. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. Okay, this is super embarrassing and I did get in trouble for this, so strap in. He's now my ex because of course he dumped my ass. He and I met in college and we were totally in love. Like, we spent every single day together and we moved in together really fast. We even stopped going to parties just to be together. About 3 years into the relationship, I told him that I definitely wanted to get married. He told me that he just wasn't ready. Then everything got really bad. He became really cold towards me. When I confronted him about it, he was honest and he told me that he just didn't love me anymore. Then he moved out and literally cut me out of his life. Even his parents told me to leave him alone. So there's a pregnant girl working at the coffee shop I usually go to. I paid her $600 to pee on a pregnancy stick. I knew this was the only way I was gonna get him to marry me. I show up to my boyfriend's house, but guess who's there? He's with his ex-girlfriend sitting on the couch watching a movie. That's when I willed myself to cry and I show him the pregnancy test. Part two is up. So I show my ex the fake pregnancy test so that he can marry me. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. Mind you, his ex is sitting on the couch waiting for him to come back so that they can finish watching their stupid movie. And when he saw that the test was positive, he started to cry. I told him that we had to talk and he told his ex to leave. Then he tells his parents to come into the room and his mom also started to cry when she saw the pregnancy test. I couldn't really tell if they were happy tears or if they were like, oh no tears. That's when I told him that I fully expected him to ask me to marry him. I even told him that I was 2 months along so we could start planning the wedding. That's when he told his parents that I was right. Then he asked me to marry him. I knew that I got what I wanted, but I had no idea how I was gonna fake this pregnancy. A few days later, he moved back into our apartment. He started painting the guest room so that it could be the nursery. But here's the worst part. A month later, I was still not able to get pregnant. I didn't know what to do, so I started eating a lot of food to fake the pregnancy bump. I would eat McDonald's for breakfast and Taco Bell for dinner. Part three is up. My husband is tied to the bed, so I grab the candle and pour all the hot wax on his you-know-what. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. Kenny has already called the police at this point and they are on their way. I'm still in blind rage and my husband is still tied to the bed. That's when Kenny grabs me by the hair, takes me to the bathroom, and throws me into the tub. I landed on my arm and actually broke it. He goes to untie my husband, and that's when the police knock on the door. Well, guess what? They arrested me for assaulting my husband. I sat in a jail cell for 6 hours before my husband came to bail me out. Of course, he apologized and said he would drop the charges. Apparently, Kenny asked his wife for a divorce and is demanding that my husband and I get divorced because he wants to be with my husband. My husband basically said that he doesn't know who to choose, me or him. I really do love my husband. What do I do? Once he saw I had money, he asked me out on a date. I had been crushing on him for more than a year, so I said yes. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. We set up a date and it went really well. He paid for dinner and congratulated me on all my success. After that, we started hanging out almost every single weekend. And about a month later, he asked me to be his girlfriend and I was so happy. I had my dream job. I lost weight. I looked damn good. And I got the perfect boyfriend too. But this is when he got toxic. He would start to criticize little things about my body. For example, I had a little bit of fat on my stomach and he would point that out. Or he would point out that my boobs weren't that big. And like I said in part 1, he was a trainer, so he had abs. Made me feel self-conscious, so I never got undressed in front of him. Then one day he suggested I go to a plastic surgeon. He even looked up a few in my area. Part 3 is my boyfriend actually suggested I go to a plastic surgeon because he didn't like that my boobs were small and that I had a bit of a tummy. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. I got extremely offended, of course. Then he acted like what he said was completely normal. I told him that I love my body as it was. Then he said that I still needed to do a lot of work on it. Then he insinuated that his girlfriend needs to look just as good as he does. In other words, he thought he was better looking than me. So I thought to myself, okay, sure, let's go to this plastic surgeon. But I was gonna find a way to make him pay for it. You see, at this point I was paying for a lot. I would pay for our dates and dinners. He would even sometimes ask me for gas money. We went to the plastic surgeon and I decided to get my boobies done. So I told my boyfriend that all my money was tied up in investments, that I needed him to loan me the money. He said, yeah, sure, and he transferred the money. I got the plastic surgery and it looks amazing. I've since moved to another city, blocked him on my phone and on social media, and he hasn't been able to find me. I mean, I think he kind of deserved it, but I also feel guilty. What should I do?
Let's talk about our kitties. Listen, we all smell bad. It's completely normal. Boys smell bad, just like girls smell bad, men and women. Some people have it worse than others, but let me tell you, bad smell comes from the outside of your kitty, not the inside, okay? So don't put anything in there to clean it. I am gonna show you guys what I use in order to smell good all the time. So here I have 2 products. The first one is the Petal Primer from Living Libation. This is freaking amazing. It smells delicious and it stays on all day. The second product is called Lumi. I am not sponsored, by the way, although I should be. So this is a deodorant specifically for your underarms and private areas. So if you have any smell anywhere else on your body, you can definitely apply this. It works. I can't tell you guys how much these two things work together, especially. I always smell good and even on my period, okay? That's how you know it works. I'm gonna make this a new series, so if you have any questions about your kitty, let me know.
I just got the Animal Crossing collection from ColourPop. Let's try it out.
I really like the packaging. My God, that's so cute. Here are 2 of the palettes. My God, gorgeous. And the 2 other shadow palettes, I have no idea which I'm gonna use. I'm gonna use La Belle of Lubal. I'm gonna use the shade Taylor's Ticket. Pretty. That is stunning. I know my lights don't do this justice, but look at the glitter. God, that's pretty. I love this shade so much that I just applied it to my whole lid, okay? I applied Serene Sable to the bottom. I put on lashes. I suck at putting on lashes. There are 2 pressed blushes in the collection. One is Flower Power, one is Flower Tender. I'm using Flower Tender because it goes perfect with the purple. Okay, I figured it out. This lash is a different shape than this lash, but they came in the same packaging. I applied BFF3 lip liner, and these are all the lip shades. A little bit of cherry, which it actually smells like cherry. And Incomparable. My lips are super hydrated and I love this. I'm planning my own beauty travel trip. You guys will get to travel with me and get to know me, and we're gonna do so many fun activities. We could go to Greece or Italy or Bali. The entire trip will be centered around beauty, health, and fitness. You guys know I love my detox smoothie, so I'm gonna show you all of that. And I am a holistic nutritionist, so I'll be talking to you about health and tons of fun stuff together. So if you wanna travel with me, click the link in my bio, fill out the form, super easy, takes 30 seconds. That way I can start planning the trip and we can get to know each other quick.
Story time about how I tricked my ex into paying for all of my plastic surgery. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. I repeat, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. A little backstory. I met my ex at the gym. He was actually my personal trainer. He was in really good shape while I was definitely out of shape and pudgy. He motivated me to work out and lose weight. I quickly realized I had a major crush on him. So after a full year of training, I had lost about 30 pounds. I felt really good about myself. So I mustered up the courage to tell him that I had a crush on him. But unfortunately, he told me that he never dated clients. Then he said that we still had a lot of work to do on my body anyway. It was a punch to the gut.
I decided I needed to get a new trainer because of what he said and because obviously I had a crush on him. Well, it just so happens that I landed in my dream job. I started making a lot of money. He followed me on Instagram and he started noticing it. I moved into a better apartment and I got a new car. I also got lip filler and cheek filler. That's when he calls me up and asks me on a date. I said yes right away. You'll never guess what happened next. Part 2 is up.
After I burned all of my YouTuber husband's clothes, I took all the naked pictures that the influencer sent him, and I sent them to her management. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. I wrote to her management and explained what happened. I told them that if they didn't stop working with her, I would send the pictures to TMZ. And just like I expected, within minutes, I got a reply. They begged me to delete the pictures, and they offered me $20,000 to keep my mouth shut. Of course, I said no. And that's when my husband comes home. He sees all of his clothes that I burnt. God, the look on his face was so stupid. I showed him all of my receipts. Then he confessed that he only did the dirty with her once. I literally thought they had just sent pictures to each other. Then his phone rings. Guess who it is? It's the damn influencer. She goes off on him and tells him that I'm threatening her career and that how could he be so stupid to not delete the pictures. They haven't spoken since. I still don't know what to do. Did I send the pictures to TMZ? I already filed for divorce too. I want all his money. In order to fake the pregnancy, I had to gain weight. So I started eating tons of food. I would have pizza every other day. I ate 2 pints of ice cream a day. And every time I passed by a fast food place, I would pick up something to eat. I was gaining a little bit of weight, so people believed me when I said I was pregnant. Finally, the wedding came around. I was so relieved once we were married because I knew I had to eventually go to the doctor. And I had decided that once the doctor said that I wasn't pregnant, I would put on a show and pretend that I just lost the baby. Well, when it finally happened, my husband straight up asked me if I made it all up. And I told him yes. It literally took him 1 hour to move out of the apartment. He went straight to get a restraining order, and my parents sent me to a psychiatrist. But you see, we're still married. He hasn't filed for divorce, so I think I should reach out to him. I know he and I will end up together. What do you guys think? Story time about how I caught my husband with his best friend in bed, who, by the way, is a guy. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. I knew that my husband was bi before we got married and it never bothered me. In fact, that's how we met. A few years ago, I was dating this guy and we had an open relationship and he would tell me about this other guy that he was hooking up with. Well, he introduced me to his male friend and we actually ended up hooking up. A few months later, we became boyfriend and girlfriend, and a few years later, we got married. So I always knew my husband was bi. Here's when his best friend comes into the picture. Let's call him Kenny. Kenny's been best friends with my husband for over 7 years. They've known each other longer than I've known my husband. But get this, Kenny is also married. Kenny would sometimes sleep over our house when it was really late. A few weeks ago, he slept over. I went to bed, but at 4 a.m, I wake up and my husband is not in bed. So I go looking for him and I hear a noise coming from the guest bedroom. I walk in and see that my husband is tied to the bed. Guess what they were doing? Part 2 is up. So I show my ex the fake pregnancy test so that he can marry me. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. Mind you, his ex is sitting on the couch waiting for him to come back so that they can finish watching their stupid movie. And when he saw that the test was positive, he started to cry. I told him that we had to talk and he told his ex to leave. Then he tells his parents to come into the room and his mom also started to cry when she saw the pregnancy test. I couldn't really tell if they were happy tears or if they were like, oh no, tears. That's when I told him that I fully expected him to ask me to marry him. I even told him that I was 2 months along so we could start planning the wedding. That's when he told his parents that I was right. Then he asked me to marry him. I knew that I got what I wanted, but I had no idea how I was gonna fake this pregnancy. A few days later, he moved back into our apartment. He started painting the guest room so that it could be the nursery. But here's the worst part. A month later, I was still not able to get pregnant. I didn't know what to do, so I started eating a lot of food to fake the pregnancy bump. I would eat McDonald's for breakfast and Taco Bell for dinner. Part 3 is up.
Once he saw I had money, he asked me out on a date. I had been crushing on him for more than a year, so I said yes. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. We set up a date and it went really well. He paid for dinner and congratulated me on all my success. After that, we started hanging out almost every single weekend. And about a month later, he asked me to be his girlfriend and I was so happy. I had my dream job. I lost weight. I looked damn good. And I got the perfect boyfriend too. But this is when he got toxic. He would start to criticize little things about my body. For example, I had a little bit of fat on my stomach and he would point that out. Or he would point out that my boobs weren't that big. And like I said in part one, he was a trainer, so he had abs. Made me feel self-conscious, so I never got undressed in front of him. Then one day he suggested I go to a plastic surgeon. He even looked up a few in my area. Part three is